back now with, I believe it's the fourth training log in the training log series in the lead up to Ironman Australia. This week, another pretty solid week with volume. We had about 19 and a half hours. It's a little down from last week, but there was some added intensity. So all in all, I'd say it's pretty much another consistent week around that same level. If we break it down, this week we had the same as always, about 10K of swimming, so 3 hours in the pool. We had cycling about 320K on the road this week, a few of those done on the trainer, so again, 320-ish K. Pretty consistent to last week though. It was about 10 hours, 35 minutes of cycling. And finally, running, we just did about 60K this week, so a little down on the running, still about 5 hours of running throughout the week. So the swim and the ride, pretty consistent. The run we cut short a little bit just because we had a pretty hot run today for the long run. So we'll talk about that one later. But all in all, I'd say it's a pretty good week. Jumping into the sessions. First of all, on Monday, we just had a 4K swim made up mostly of 200s and 100 meter reps. So nothing too exciting there, just your basic swim. And Monday afternoon, where we would typically do an easy bike, this week we added some intensity to it. So as I was saying before, yes, the volume as far as total hours dropped, but we did add some intensity in. So still pretty much the same. But yeah, with the Monday ride, mostly easy, but we just had 15 1 minute strength efforts. So it's 15 by 1 minute at 260-ish watts. Just holding a cadence of around 50 RPM. So a good little strength set there, but the rest was all done pretty cruisy, like 160-ish watts. Having a look at Tuesday now, as always, we had that Tuesday threshold bike session, so that real FTP builder. They kind of become like key sessions, I guess, especially on the channel. It's a bit of a talking point, so I'll cut now some footage that I filmed throughout that workout so you can get a bit of an insight. But it's basically 3 by 15 minutes at 260 watts with 5 minutes at 150. So last week was 4 by 12 minutes at 260 watts. The week before that was 3 by 12 minutes. And the week before, I could not do the workout basically. And then last week, I smashed the workout. So I honestly don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this one or not. It's like 30 degrees at the moment, so it's gonna be a pretty good test as far as like handling it in the heat. And I do have a lot more, like last week was a pretty big week, so there's a lot more fatigue in my legs now. So honestly, I don't know if I'll finish it, but I'll give it a go. You can talk back, like, you can just talk if you want. You don't have to just... Finished the first rep, heart rate got to like 185, so it was pretty tough, but the good thing is this week the rest in between is 5 minutes at 150 watts compared to last week it was 4 minutes at 200, so I'm actually getting a chance to fully recover, which is a welcome change. I start cooling out my hair. I'm gonna cover myself with the ashes of you, and nobody's gonna give a damn. Son of a bitch, give me a drink. One more night, but this can't be me. Son of a bitch, if I can't get clean. Finished the second rep. Heart rate was at like 192, so I'd call that max effort.
For 17 years I've been going in back. 17 more will bury me. And somebody please just tie me down. Oh, somebody give me a goddamn drink. Son of a bitch, give me a drink. One more night, this can't be me. Son of a bitch, if I can't get clean.
third rep, had to stop and take a few rests with that one, so I'd say that's right on my limits for today, maybe a little over. So yeah, pretty tough session. I'd say right on my limits of what I could actually do that day. It was a pretty hot day. It was like 30 something degrees, which for all the Americans watching, that's like 265 degrees Fahrenheit or somewhere around there. So yeah, pretty hot conditions to be riding a bike, and all I've got is like this tiny little Kmart fan in a nice hot shed. So a bit of heat prep and good mental toughness training, I guess, is one way to look at it. And then Tuesday afternoon, we just had the typical strength set. So again, mainly just injury prevention, just looking for some basic leg strength and core stability with those sessions. And then that takes us to Wednesday now. So Wednesday morning, 3.3K swim. Most of that was basically, 100s and 200 meter reps. Had a quick chat with the coach. And the good thing about doing reps of like 100 meters or 50 meters is you get a lot of concurrent feedback. So you know at the end of a lap, if you check your watch and notice how fast that lap was, you get some feedback on things you might change in your technique. So I'm learning a lot, I think, from doing a lot of reps over and over as far as adjusting my form and sort of catch positions and body position in the water to figure out what works and what doesn't work. So it's a lot of data points you're getting throughout a session. So I really enjoy the way we're doing that one. Wednesday afternoon was about a 15K run. We had 30 minutes at race pace and 1 mile just all out hard basically. So I was feeling pretty good on that one. I think my 30 minute effort was a bit above race pace. It was like down in the 440s. And then my 1 mile all out was pretty good. I got that one like below 4 minute K pace. So that was pretty fast, but I was really trying not to look at the watch and just run it based on effort. I hear a lot of people say that you shouldn't really worry about specific paces, so I was spending a lot of time just looking at the time on my watch, but not really the pace, so just trying to run by feel. So it was good to get about 30 minutes of like race prep in my mind, sort of visualization on how it should feel, and then to go for 1 mile pretty hard. That was mainly the session. Ended up being about an hour and 15 minutes, about 5 minutes per kilometer pace, and total 15K work. So Thursday we had a session. I'll read what the coach wrote on this one. It was a session called Ocean of Lactic. He said here, you know a good session is coming when you see a title like this. We want to teach the body to clear lactic at Ironman Power. So essentially what we're doing here, if I look at the workout builder, it's just a steady warm up for like half an hour at a pretty cruisy pace, but then it's 5 minutes at 230 watts, which is 85% of my FTP. It's 1 minute at 300 watts, which is 110% of my FTP, so that's really jacking the lactic up in the legs. And then it's 5 minutes back down at 204 watts, which is supposedly what my Ironman Power will be. So it's trying to teach my body really to clear that lactic out of my legs while we're still pushing 204 watts. So that was it. You get 3 rounds of that with 5 minutes recovery at 150 watts. That was the main set. Thursday was a double bike day though, so we haven't done double bike days for a while, not since I started the training log series at least. So it was good to get a nice just 55 minute aerobic spin in the legs that afternoon. It was a bit of a skill set, so we had a bunch of cadence changes in there, but it was all done pretty cruisy at like 170-ish watts. Cut it down to 55 minutes just to fit it into my lunch break at work, but apart from that, pretty steady ride. And Friday morning, we had a 3K swim with the main set. It was quite a fun one. We got to do 40 by 50, leaving on 1 minute. So I'll throw the paces up here just so you can have a look at them. Definitely nothing impressive as far as swim speed, but it was a good fun set for me to do. And like I mentioned before, a lot of concurrent feedback doing 40, 50 meter reps. Get a lot of data points there so you figure out what works and what doesn't work. And then Friday afternoon, I jumped on the treadmill just to try and ease off a bit of fatigue and really hit paces specifically. Also to escape the heat, it's been like above 30 degrees every day here lately. So jumped inside to get in the aircon. 17K with the main set just being 5K. I did that at 4:30 pace, and then a 1 mile effort pretty much all out. And I just ran that at about 4 minutes per kilometer pace, which is about my 5K race pace, give or take. Totaled out at 17K of work. We averaged 4 minutes 50 per kilometer. Took about an hour and 20 minutes. So pretty steady run in the legs. There was only three runs this week, so we didn't have a lot of chances to get much volume in. So nothing too crazy there. Saturday morning's ride, bit of an interesting one this week. We had planned 6 hours. I did cut it short at 5 hours, 45 minutes. So pretty much 6 hours, almost went the whole way. But just wasn't quite feeling it on that session. I mean, fatigue-wise, I felt fine. Energy-wise, I felt fine. Just couldn't really get into a good rhythm on the bike. It was almost like I didn't have a feel for the road. So one thing I do want to work on in the future now is getting out on the road throughout the week more rather than just being on the trainer. Just to quite, I suppose, get a feel for the road almost. Yeah, they talk about getting a feel for the water a lot in swimming, and it's almost like I feel like I want to try and get a bit more of a feel for how I should be like performing on a bike on the real road rather than a lot of my sessions which have been done on the trainer. So that's one thing I'm going to focus on. Also going to book in for a bike fit too, so really get my position honed in properly. But I mean, as far as sessions go, it was still, you know, 165k, so it's not a bad ride to get in the legs. Speed was off, power was weird. It was pretty windy, so I suppose that drops the speed down. Weather was kind of weird, but I think mentally it was just a bit of an off ride for me. Nothing to worry about though. We did add a brick on, so it's the first brick session we've been able to do since the training log series started. It's just a 10 minute run off the bike. I tried to go super cruisy on the first K, so 5 minutes out, I was trying to run really slow because people always say everyone runs too fast off the bike. Everyone jumps off the bike and just sprints off. So one thing I want to get in the habit of is running the first K easy and then jacking it up to race pace. So basically went out at like 5 minutes 30 per kilometer and then cut it back down to like 4 minutes 50 per kilometer for the 5 minutes back home to try and even it out basically. So yeah, around about 2K, 5 minutes per kilometer pace. And then that takes us to Sunday's long run. Today's long run, always the best way to end the week. Now, I didn't do this one in the morning, really probably should have, because when I ran this one, it was 33 degrees Celsius, which for the Americans watching, that's like 426 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's pretty hot conditions to be running in as far as trying to hold any kind of decent pace for 2 hours or above. Now, the coach does write on these, just like the other long runs, aim for at least 2 hours, but if the body's feeling good and you love me, you'll make it to 32 kilometers or thereabouts. Now, I mean, I did try, but look, I cut that one at 24 kilometers because I was getting dehydrated and I was getting hot, okay? So if you look at my heart rate, I was like running 5 minutes 20 per kilometer with 175 beats per minute in the heart. So I was working hard. I mean, it was only a 2 hour run. It was only 520 per kilometer, but it was probably still up there with some of the hardest runs I've ever done, honestly. So look, if it just happens to be record heat waves in Ironman Australia this year in May, I'm going to be the most prepared. That's the way I think of it, but that would be like global warming to the next level. So hopefully that doesn't happen, but that's one of the reasons why the volume time was a bit down this week is because I did cut that Sunday long run down a bit. And the run volume's down a bit too because of that. But honestly, I still feel like I got quite a good benefit from it, even only on 2 hours of running 24K. And that wraps it up for the week. So again, another solid week. We've got a pretty good one coming again next week. Volume's probably going to be up just a touch from this week. The run certainly should be up because I'll do that one as anyone should actually do a run, which is in sensible conditions. But apart from that, all the other sessions are pretty much the same. So it's going to be another solid week before we do a rest week after that. Okay, so that'll basically give us 3 consecutive weeks of pretty solid training in the legs. But yeah, that's it for this week's video.